This Starlink Mini has wings. So this is the striker mount for the Starlink Mini, and this is actually a really nice design. It's got an aluminum back. It has a nice plastic handle on top. It's got a secret area for an air tag in case your Starlink Mini gets stolen. And now they've come out with these wings with these humongous suction cups. And notice that the suction cups face up, right? So if you have a car that has a sunroof like mine, this goes up onto the sunroof. And then you can use the Starlink Mini while you're driving, and it works perfectly fine right through that sunroof. So let's go ahead and get this thing suction cupped up to the top, and then we're gonna test it out. Did you know that new Starlink customers can get a free month of service? That's right. If you use my link below in the description, when you sign up for your Starlink service, you can save yourself a decent amount of cash by getting 1 month free. Combine that with the steep discounts that they're offering on the residential dish, and the cost to get yourself Starlink satellite internet is as low as ever. And remember, if you need help setting up your dish or configuring your network to work with Starlink, Rogue Support is here to help. Just visit us on the web at rogue.support to get the help you need today. All right, so I'm gonna plug in the cable first. I'm using this barrel to USB-C cable right here. This will keep it weather tight, even though it doesn't matter because we're doing this inside the car, but it is a nice option to have. And Starlink hasn't come out with their weatherproof USB-C cable yet. All right, power is in. Let's get it up here. All right, so that is up there and it is stuck good. It is not moving at all. Let's go ahead and get it plugged in. Now I'm using this Anchor Prime power bank to do this. We're just gonna go ahead and plug in the USB-C, and now we're gonna let the Starlink Mini fire up. All right, so I wasn't even sure if this was gonna connect in this location because I'm under some seriously heavy tree cover, but I checked my phone. It is connected to the Starlink Mini wireless. Let's see if I get any speed whatsoever from this location. All right, running my speed test now. All right, and we got 45 megabit down by 4.18 megabit up. That's actually pretty amazing, but let's get on the road and see what kind of speeds we can achieve. Driving down the road on the highway, I am on autopilot. I'm trying to be as safe as possible here, but we're gonna run another speed test. All right, so driving down the highway at 60 miles an hour, we are getting 142 megabits down by 11.8 megabits up. So Starlink Mini attached to the underside of my sunroof works perfectly fine in motion. I've never had a problem with the orientation. Right now I'm driving south, so it's actually kind of facing the wrong way even, but I'm still getting some pretty impressive speeds. So this is gonna be great for our next super long road trip.
Quick little postscript to that video. I made that for TikTok, and I've grown that TikTok channel to over 32,000 followers. I post a lot of content to TikTok that I do not post to YouTube, so if you're interested in seeing some more Crosstalk content, be sure to check that out. And a couple of things that I wanted to make clear based on comments from that TikTok video. First, yes, the suction cups on the striker mount can face either up or down. So if you don't have a sunroof inside your car, you can absolutely flip those over and then just put it right on top of your roof. Now, I drove around for over 8 hours with the bigger Starlink Gen 3 dish affixed to the roof of my car, and it was perfectly fine. Additionally, many people said that attaching these powerful suction cups to the glass on top of your car can warp or bend the glass to the point where it cracks or breaks. So, you know, anecdotally, I have not had this happen to me, nor have I personally heard about this happening to anyone that I know. I also reached out to the guy who makes these striker mounts, and he said he hadn't heard of any cases of sunroofs breaking with suction cups either. Now, if you search online, you will find a lot of folks who say that having suction cups on glass can be a problem, but there's not a lot of firsthand accounts of sunroofs actually breaking or cracking because of it. So again, I personally see very little evidence of danger when it comes to affixing the Starlink to your sunroof, but I'm certainly gonna report back if that changes. And if you're concerned about a suction cup damaging your sunroof, then just don't use suction cups on your sunroof, right? You do have that option. I also received a ton of comments telling me that I am irradiating my brain by having the Starlink dish inside the car. And without getting too far into the specifics of non-ionizing radiation, the Starlink Mini runs on USB-C and pulls like 20 or 30 watts max. So it doesn't seem to me like it's that much of a danger. But in the pursuit of being scientific about it, I bought myself an EMF meter, which measures electromagnetic frequencies in volts per meter, or volts per like ambient meter around the device. The International Commission on Non-Ionizing Radiation Protection, or ISINRP, has a recommended limit of public exposure to EMF at 83 volts per meter. But there's a separate occupational limit for folks who work around a lot of EMF exposure that is set to 420 volts per meter. Let's measure the Starlink Mini.
All right, so testing out the Starlink Mini away from the dish, we've got a baseline of about 17 or 18 volts per meter, and let's bring it right on top of the dish. So you can hear the alarm going off, and we are averaging out at about 480 volts per meter right in front of the dish, which is actually quite a lot. That's more than you would want to be exposed to continuously. However, taking the meter behind the dish up underneath it here, it's significantly lower at about 77 volts per meter. So it definitely appears to be some sort of shielding on the back of the Starlink Mini.
So in my opinion, and based on actual factual measurements, I think having the Starlink Mini in the car with you is relatively low risk, given that it appears to be shielded on the underside of the dish. However, if you're still concerned about Starlink EMF levels, I'm gonna add a special tinfoil hat to my online store that's gonna be guaranteed to protect you from having your brain fried. It's just $59.95. Okay, so links to everything down in the description below, and remember, you can get a free month of Starlink service if you use my refer link. And if you'd like to keep this party going, I have hand-selected a couple of videos on the right here for you to watch next. The top video is my full review of the Starlink Mini, and the bottom video is my recent look at the brand new unified device bridge.